Hey guys, how's it going? My name's Dolly's and welcome back to Sky Factory 2.5. I had to think there for a second to make sure this was, in fact, Sky Factory. It is. Last time, we did a little bit of magic stuff with Batania because I really didn't have much else to do, so I figured let's do some Batania and see what that would get us. Because most of what we've been doing the last couple of episodes is waiting. So I want to kill the witch. But I want to do so as safely as possible, and that has been a struggle. But the struggle's almost done. So, couple things. One, I have a whole bunch of cows in here. I think I'm going to kill them all. Let's kill all the cows. Hey, we got a cow's head. We got a loot box. Or loot bag, rather. So cool. We got some cows. I spawned them in with the safari net. But today we are going to hopefully be able to make most of the stuff that we need to in order to summon the wither and kill the wither. So I'm trying to get just a little bit more draconium, but we don't need that much more. We have enough for, I believe it's like this. Nope. 24 draconium infused obsidian, and this is wither resistant stuff. Now before we do much else, I have a whole bunch of loot boxes and stuff to open. Let's cook up some food and see, we have worn out loot bags. This is always going to be cake. So let's get those into this system. I don't know why the cakes are not coming over here, but they aren't, so let's fix that. Get some power in this hole. Actually, that's just going to generate power. Whatever. I stole a power line, so let's replace it. So there we go. Alright, so what else do we have? We have a rare loot bag. Has a world interaction upgrade. Okay, that's fine. We got this, which has some really good food. Octanic capacitor, which is really nice. Crimson cultist stuff, which is cool. We have an epic loot bag with some blue slimy. Great wood sapling. So I already looked at these and I kind of picked them out. And the reason I'm grabbing them is because they have good stuff. The Greatwood Sapling is awesome because otherwise, that's not as bad as I thought it was going to be. Otherwise, that'd be, usually that's a nasty little thing to do. But let's see, that in there. How close are we to, not very close. Crimson Cultist Robes, that can go in here. I have a whole bunch of researches to do as well. So we have portable pole, infernal one core, which is something we're gonna want to make one of these days, and just all of this stuff. We kind of went through last time and picked out a bunch of stuff to look at, so let's just get all of this, and we have enough draconium to make one more set of infused obsidian, so maybe we can make it a little bit safer to do the things we need to. I got an alder sapling somewhere, so I figured I'd show that. Let's see, we have uncommon treasure, mostly gold, some potions I don't really care about. We got an ender pearl, some more potions I don't really care about. Okay, so let's throw most of the stuff in here. Let's see, the capacitor can go in here. This is a top tier capacitor, which is really nice to get. See, most of the stuff can go in here or in here. I put the cultist stuff in there, but whatever. Let's just get our inventory cleaned out a little bit and we'll get some food over there as well. So, I guess first thing is first, let's get the draconium out. We're going to want a lot of this stuff in the future, but there's easier ways to get it. Once we get access to them, we're not going to be bothering with making endstone, I don't think. But we can make, hopefully, one more set. Alright, do I have... let's get the blaze powder. 1, 2, 3, 4. And we'll make one more set of the draconium-infused obsidian. There we go. So, 28. That's not too bad. Now, let's focus on some other things. So, first of all, I need to get a bucket. Before I can summon the Wither, I'm going to need one, better weapons, and two, the Wither Skulls. I don't have those yet. Now, I finally got enough pink slime to... Let's build a little place for it to do this. So we'll just encircle an area. We'll put the pink slime bucket in there, and it will eventually congeal. Given enough time, and become a pink slime, and that is what I want. So I don't know why it's taking so long, but we'll just let it kind of set for a minute, because it should congeal and then give us a pink slime, and that is what we're going to make our crossbow out of. Now there we go. So we have the pink slime. I'm going to want to keep this guy for a long time. So let's spawn a couple in. We need more essence. And we're going to want to kill these guys to get as much pink slime as we can get. So... let's just let it go. We've got 5, 8, we've got about 12 or so pink slime. We have a decent amount. 14. Oh, hey, I got a slime head. And that's all it can do. So we're gonna... let's see, I need to get... One, I need more gas tiers. So what we might do... Gas tiers are soul sand sifted. So let's come back over here. And do I have enough nether ore essence? I do have enough for a little bit, so that's what we're gonna do. Let's get the... I start growing redstone in front of this guy, and just to do something. Let's see, rare loot bag stack upgrade. That's nice and expensive, but not something I want. And stuff I don't really want. So, I will throw those into the assemblers over here. Let's see, that goes in there. And that goes in there. Right? Yes. Alright. So, I'll let that just kind of do its thing. And I want to make some soul sand. I don't remember the recipe. Okay. Like so. And we can go ahead and put this guy in here. Hopefully get a gas tier. Eventually I'm going to need like 5 gas tiers. But whatever amount I can get is enough. Let's see, recipe, uses, that's what I wanted. So, pink slime is much like all the other slimes. It is a slime ball, but let's see, where is it? Over here. So crossbow, limb, pink slime. Now, can I just make it straight out of this stuff? No. So, let's look at the book. Materials in you. I don't know which one it's going to be. Alright, so slimy mud. So let's just look at all the uses of pink slime, because I'm not entirely sure how to go about making pink slime tools. I don't think I've ever done it before. I wonder if it's just the pink slime blocks. Oh, there it is, pink slime crystals. Okay, so we're gonna need a lot more, I think. Let's make one. And if I need to go over and make more, that's not an issue. So let's see if one is enough. I doubt that it's going to be. Nope. Okay, so we're gonna need more pink slime. That's not a problem. Let's just get some more pink slime spawned. Let's get rid of this. And this is gonna let us make a decent bow. Crossbow specifically. And then the other thing that we're gonna do is we need to get a a couple other things, but the big thing that we're going to need is something to behead stuff a little bit more consistently. So we're going to make a cleaver. We're just going to make that maybe out of manulin, because I have a little trick with the manulin. We'll see though. So let's just kill a bunch of these guys. More pink slimes is always better, because eventually we're going to probably make a laser from MFR, which will let us get more stuff. So I'm trying to think. It's almost three. Let's get just a little bit more and see if that's enough. So it's idling. Because it doesn't have the pink slime in there. That would be the issue. Anything good? Ooh, Yalorium. Take that. Alright, so let's kill more pink slimes. And we don't have any more power, but that's not too big of a deal. We can get more power easily. So let's do that. Let's back, and yeah, that still has plenty of power, so we should have all the pink slime that we need now, at least for the time being. Let's get three more crystals, and while that is cooking up, I'm gonna throw this loot bag. I can let my system sort it out, and slime can go in there. Awesome. So, do we get any gas tears? No. That's a bummer, but whatever. Let's throw Yalorium in here, and let's make this slimy crossbow. There we go. So that should be everything I need. So we have... No, I still need the body, and that's... Do I want to make that out of pink slime as well? Let's make it out of manulin. That will be easier. So what we're going to do with the crossbow body... I have a manulin cow here. I've had this guy for a while. I've been collecting stuff from him, and Now we're going to use it. So, typically, the only way to get liquids into the smeltery is through the drain. So, let's just put this guy here. That didn't connect. That's good. Put the liquid transposer there. Wrong way. And we'll fill it up with molten manilium. So we have 41 ingots. Wow. So let's make the crossbow body. And then we're just going to make a couple other things. So one, we're going to want the crossbow. And we also want the bolts. Now I have to remember how to make that stuff. So let's clean up the inventory just a little bit. Put that in there. Alright, so the crossbow is, that's right, the string, the limb, obsidian, and manulin. So if we look at the stats, draw speed is 1.5 seconds, which is really good. We will improve that more later, but the other thing we're going to need to do is take this guy out. We're going to put the tool rod down, and we're going to, it's not the tough rod, it's just a normal rod. I think we might need that for the, what's it called? The cleaver. So once that cools, we will have a bolt, manulin bolt. So it's gonna break almost every time, but that's okay. We have large blade. Let's get that casted, and then I've got to figure out what all I'm gonna need for the cleaver. So we need two tough rods, a plate, and the large blade. So you need another tough rod. That is the tough rod, right? Yes. How much more manual? Oh, plenty. And then large plate. And we're gonna make a sword as well out of this stuff. But we'll get there in just a moment. So let's make all of this stuff. So first things first, let's make the bolts. It is just the manulin bolt with the fletching. We're going to get 420 bolts. Break chance is not too bad. Accuracy is good. Attack damage isn't very good, but we can improve that, so that's not a big deal. We're going to improve it with quartz, which we'll get to in a minute. And then we're going to make the cleaver. So, blade, the rods, and then that. We'll make 7 hearts versus, okay. So this has a 20% chance of beheading. Now, if I get that book out again, it's volume 2. Where is volume 2? Why am I blind? There it is. Volume 2. So if we look at volume 2, modifiers, we're going to want to up the beheading. We want to have basically as high as we can get. So beheading is a piece of obsidian and an ender pearl. That I can do. So let's get some ender pearls and turn that on. Let's get some more obsidian. We're going to want a ball of moss. We're going to want actually a couple of ball of mosses. Which, if I look, how do we get that? Ball of moss. Just some sort of mossy stone. Which, can I get that easily? Nature essence. Okay, so we're going to want, like, a decent amount to get Let's just get a little bit of the mossy stone. There we go. 1, 2. And the ball of moss is, what that does is it repairs your tools automatically. It's actually really nice. So, the reason I want to grab it, also I need to eat. I also need to figure out where I keep all my ender pearls. Both these are mature though, so let's replant. So let's see. I'm gonna want two more of those. We'll get one more ball of moss. And what we're gonna do is we are going to put, let's see, how many modifiers do we have on this? None. So we can't put a ball of moss on that. But we should be able to, we can put one ball of moss on the crossbow. I don't think I want to do that yet. So we need more modifiers, and once again, I need to look at the book. So in order to get more modifiers, there's a couple of things you can do. One of the easiest is to get there. A block of gold and a diamond, and then nether stars, and that will be much, much later. So a block of gold and some diamond will work. So I want two of those. And you can only do these once each, which is somewhat of a bummer, but it is what it is. So I want modifier on that and on that. Now we can put the ball of moss on both of those. They both have auto repair. They will level up as we go. But let's get some more obsidian. Let's turn that off. And we'll up the beheading chance. Now, this, does it have any modifiers? Yes. So we can get some redstone. Do I have enough? You know what? Let's. I don't have enough diamonds, do I? I need to get more diamonds. I don't really have that much redstone at the time either, so we'll just go with what we have. And as we use this stuff more often, we will get more modifiers. So for the time being, let's go ahead and get into this. So the nether quartz, once we have the stuff, surface quartz is actually really good for this, but let's also make a better sword. So I'm going to make, let's just make a normal sword. So sword blade. We're going to make this one a little bit different. Where is, I know I have it somewhere. Apologies about the helicopter in the background. It is really loud. And it is flying overhead. I really need to get organized. Wow. Where did I know I have magic. Oh, it's in here. Alright, so we're going to want a wide guard. We'll make it out of magical wood. And I don't really need to make anything else right now, so we'll just throw this stuff in here. So we have Manulin's sword blade. And let's get tool rod. So what this is going to do is let us make a halfway decent sword, to be honest. So our flint broadsword was okay, but it wasn't that good. But we make a Manulin broadsword, which has two modifiers. We come over here. I do believe we can put Surtis quartz. I believe that counts. No, what about normal quartz? Because if I can use this stuff, then that will be great, but Yes, we can. Cool. So it gives you a lot. And there we go. We have a 6.5 hearts of damage sword. That as we use it is going to get even better. So that is something that we're going to do with most of this stuff once it all levels up. Now getting it to level up is a different story altogether. But let's get I do need some sort of safari net or something. There's all the ender pearls. Let's put them together. Do I have any more safari nets? How did I get the one? I believe it was a loot bag. I'm gonna see. Oh, I had a whole bunch of balls moss. So let's see. We have another jailer's. That'll work. I just don't want to lose the pink slime. Eventually we will get more. We'll get more stuff in terms of. Oh, so like, we'll get more reusable safari nets. So there's the pink slime. Let's get that guy in there. Fill that up. No energy, which is good. So I don't want that doing anything yet. Let's get the power supply. And put that there. So this is going to start spawning. Okay, we need to spawn exact copy. I forgot about that. So we need more essence. That's not a problem. Come over here. Rare loot bag that can go in here. I don't know why. Throw that stuff in there. Alright, cool. So we should be able to put that there. I was expecting it to fill up a little bit more than it did. Let's put that in there and let's get the XP shower. And I don't know why it didn't finish, but cool. So it is pretty much full of essence. Grab all this stuff, and we'll put all of our experience back in here. Alright, so let's make some. Thought I put that in there. Alright, let's go make some wither skeletons. We'll kill them, hopefully, get their heads, and be done with this part. So, Manual and Cleaver will let us behead. It is slow. It gives you Mining Fatigue 3. This takes a lot. We got one. But that takes way too much. Let's try something else. Let's take this out. And what we're going to do is something a little weird. Because I think it's going to be the best option to get the Wither Skull heads without having to worry about other things. So let's just throw this stuff in here. And get our bucket. And what we're going to do is we're going to get a bucket of water. So witch water will turn skeletons into wither skeletons. So what I'm going to do is just spawn a whole bunch of normal skeletons in here, and then so We just throw that in there and then run. We'll make a little platform out here. And then we'll just dump witch water on all of the skeletons in there. So that should be a little bit easier. I don't know if there's a better way to spawn skeletons. I did notice, however, that some of these spawn eggs do work. There is recipes for them. There is no way to spawn villagers, but there is a way to get villagers. We'll do that later. But there's a portal to the last millennium. This guy, which we could actually go ahead and do, will give us access to villagers, but let's see. Let's just boop. And then there's two. Now it's out of essence. Let's make sure it has plenty of essence. Let more spawn. I also want the F7 up, just so I know. Let's get their attention, get them all over in this corner, and then I'll just drench them in the witch water and kill them. We only need one more skull, and we can do the whole wither killing thing, or at least attempt to. So, wait for it to disappear. There we go, we have all the skulls now. Awesome. So, that just means it's time to finish the preparing for the wither. We have all the ingredients, we just need to do it now. And that is honestly terrifying. I have a base that is easily destroyed. I have a base that is easily destroyed by a wither. So I really don't want. Let's test out our there we go. Let's test out our crossbow. There should be a zombie in this tree. But yeah, I want to be careful with how I... There he is. One-shotted. That's nice. And it reloads decently fast, so... Very accurate. I like this crossbow. This was a good crossbow to make. But yeah, so there is the issue of the wither killing us and destroying the entire area, which is why I made the obsidian. I'm debating right now if I want to go for it and just do it, or if I want to wait. I'm leaning towards waiting till next episode. I know, it sucks, but there's a few more things I would like to prepare. Namely, I want to get... The one big thing that I want to get is potions. So I've been getting a lot of instant... we're full on zombie flesh. So I'll deal with that in a minute. So one of the things that I've been getting a lot of is healing potions. But not so much with... we have miniature rip hearts. We could... We do have a couple of necrotic bones as well. We could do something with that. But yeah, so I've been getting a lot of potions. Do I have any potions of strength? I do. Speed. How about regen? That's a nice potion of strength. Regen 2. Alright, that's not too bad. You know what? I might regret this. Rushing into this is never a good idea. Let's get... see, a bunch of cobblestone. I'm going to put my cleaver in here. And basically anything I don't need. Lexicontainment, go in there. And that can go in there. The miniature red parts, I'm realizing what these are used for. I do have a golden apple, a notch apple. So what the red hearts are used for is making these miniature red heart containers, canisters, which gives you more health, but it requires these jeweled apples, which are diamonds. So a notch apple might be what we want. So let's, you know what, let's do it over here. I have 28. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Something like this, maybe. Put torches around it. I don't have enough. Yeah, I can make that. So what are some of the other wither resistant? There's weatherproof obsidian, which is a lot of dark steel. Can I make that from anything? Halfway easily. Steel and obsidian. Or iron. Okay. Can I make. No. Okay, so. Dark steel is an option. Let's see, how much dark steel do I have? So to make four, that's really expensive. Otherwise, we need the Zavisio essence, which you need the Nether Star to make anyway, so. Yeah, what to do? I'm really debating what I want to do at this point. I think one of the best things that I could do, there's a couple of things I could do actually. More dimlets would be good. Because I can get, honestly, I could get wither dimlets. That would be really neat, but I wonder. Okay, I can make that with Gaia spirits, or I can get them from legendary loot bags. There's also the end cake, which would let me go to the end. That is not bad to get. Dimlets. So, unknown dimlets come from epic loot bags. And that's the only way. They are also a drop from Enderman. So that is a thing I could do as well. I think I'm going to go ahead and call this episode here. We still need a lot of some sort of wither-resistant block just to make sure that we don't die. And then once I can fly, I can pick all that stuff up. That's not going to be a problem. But I just don't want to die. Did this fill up with water? No. Okay. So, yeah. I'm gonna need to get a lot of draconium. And in order to do that, we're. Let's see, there's no way to get draconium ore. Draconium dust we've been getting through mostly just the draconium ore dust, but that's super slow. There is also draconium nuggets, no. And yeah, that's not very good, but wow, that is expensive. All right, so we need common loot bags. Commonly have draconium. Let's see if we can't get some more draconium. We're gonna open a bunch of common loot bags. That's what does this sometimes. So let's get the epics. And what we're gonna do is we are going to craft these into commons. And you know what? Let's do this. So, what was that one thing? What is that? Limestone. Okay. So no draconium yet, but this might be what we need to do. There's lapis and coal. I'll take those. Actually, I do want to stand over here, because what we're gonna do is drop them in there. So let's get more. The epic loot bags turn into rares. That's gonna be a good way to get a lot. So I'll take the coal. No draconium. All right, so this is going to be fun. And see, we can get wow. Yeah, we're gonna have a lot. So what I might do is off camera, if I can find any draconium, is just do this for a while. It is cheaty, I know, but whatever is necessary to get the draconium that we need. Am I sure that I'm looking the right ones? Legendary loot bags. Whoops. All right, then I need to throw all of this stuff back in here because I was doing it wrong. I thought it said common. I don't know why. And we'll throw that in there. I don't know why it doesn't automatically sort them, but all right, so the plan is going to be get as much draconium as I can and go from there. So we need to just build an area that is wither resistant, and we can hopefully take on the wither in the next episode. So I'm gonna end it here. I kind of got sidetracked looking for stuff. I am going to. I'm trying to think. I might expand the Enderman seeds. I might also make this farm a little more automated. Think if I make a 3x3 completely automated Enderman essence crop farm, this might be better. So I think that's what I'm gonna do. So that's something. You know what? Let's set that up right now. That won't take too long. I already have the planter. Let's get our inventory sorted. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There we go. Something like that. Let's do that real quick, and then we can end the episode and go from there. So, we're going to want to kill that skeleton in a second. So, we're going to want 9 dirt. Let's try to level up our stuff. So, lapis can. No. Alright, so, we're gonna want 9 dirt. We're going to want the planter. I thought it was in there. It's in here, isn't it? So we're gonna put, let's see, where's somewhere we can do this that's right here. Right here looks good. So we're gonna want this. Put the nine dirt in a minute. Next we're going to want this guy. And this guy. So we put the dirt like so. The harvest, actually, we're gonna get the stuff soon enough, so let's put it in the ground. We're gonna get flight soon enough, so this will make things a little bit easier. Although I do need access to it. So the harvester will go there. So let's get the power lines first. I think that's gonna be the easiest thing to hook up. So hardened flux ducts. I'm gonna make more off camera, so let's just steal some of these. Shouldn't need that many. Like I said, I'll make more off camera. I just want to get this set up real quick so that I can go on with my day. Do that. We'll put the solar panel. Actually, let's do this and then the solar panel. Actually, that's not what we want either. So let's do. Can I get these? No. Alright. Put that there. We need. The harvester will go right here. And, you know, we could have had it like we did, but oh well. Again, I'll get the supplies to make those. Put that there. Put that on top of it. That'll power both machines. And then all we need to do is... Do I have another item filter? Or item transfer node? Let's see. I should have one, right? Do I have an extra one laying around somewhere? Okay, if not, I can do it another way. Item ducts to filter. Let's make the transfer node, because I think that's going to be easiest. So let's get ender pearls. I'm going to need some stone. Chest. I think I'm going to need more stones. Let's just grab all the stone. We're going to need some redstone as well. Alright, so item transfer nodes. That's what they're called. So we're going to make this one. There we go. Made four of them. We're going to want some normal transfer pipes. And I believe, I can't remember how those are made. Yeah, let's just do transfer pipe. So it is aluminum, redstone, and glass. So do I should have some glass, yes. And then a little bit of aluminum, because I have a decent amount of it. Let's see, let's get... Actually, we only need six right now. So let's get this made. And we're gonna want an item filter. That's the last key element. So item filter. Just some redstone string and some sticks. So that is not difficult at all. I have another safari net. So let's go grab a single piece of string. And I should have some sticks in here. Wow. Let's put these in here. I have a legendary bag. Anything good? Draconium. Yes. Yes, indeed. So we'll make the item filter. We just need one. And put the Draconium in there for a minute. Then all we'll need to do, other than link this up, is we will take chest on the back. This is gonna be a pain. You know what? Do I have my bucket on me? I don't. So let's get a bucket of water. This is gonna be risky. So let's throw some good stuff in here. Alright, good enough. What we're gonna do is we're going to, one, secure the planter and all that fun stuff. But more importantly, we are going to place the transfer node on the bottom of the chest. So let's just do something like this. And awesome. So that should be good enough for me to, one, secure everything. Perfect. Then all we need to do is take the transfer pipes, put them down here. We are going to grab that. Let's get the Enderman crops. Get the filter. We'll put that. So this will only extract Enderman seeds. This guy should, if we do this, we cover it up, plant them. Perfect. So that is, that is the system. This is what's going to get us all of the stuff that we need. All of the Enderman seeds, essence, and then we'll be able to make crushed endstone, and then get the obsidian from that. So I'm going to call the episode here. Next time, I will have this finished, and we will take on the Wither and go from there. So I hope you guys enjoyed this episode, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!